Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1756, Resize the Print Range as Formulas Change. All right, today's question is sent in by Michael. Michael has a really great application running here to send out statements to tenants, and it uses a formula here that seems to be directly out of Mike Girvin's Ctrl+Shift+Enter book, and the bottom line is that as you change the data here, it extracts different records from this worksheet. So for example, if I Ctrl+C here, come back and paste, Ctrl+V, we get a different number of records. And Michael wants the print range to extend when we get more records, but he doesn't want it to be that large when we don't have records. Now, of course, there's formulas here, all right? So there's all these formulas returning blank cells all the way down. And if we just allowed Excel to print, it would see those formulas and include those in the print range. I'll undo here and we'll go back. All right, so my solution. First thing we want to do is set the print range. I don't care to where. It really doesn't matter. I just want to have a print area set. So print area, set print area. All right, next. We're going to come back and edit that, but I want to talk about the offset function. The offset function is a great way to dynamically resize a range in response to some sort of formula. And so as I look at his report here, there's nothing in column A. There's a heading for dates and then a number of dates. And those dates, of course, are really numeric, and that field is not numeric. So if I would ask for the equal count of column A, so ignore the currency there. It's telling me that there are 10 rows of data. And let's do a little test here. If we copy Baby Spice and paste, Ctrl+V, now it's telling me that there are 42 rows of data. All right, so that little function right there, the count of A colon A, is going to be very useful in figuring out how large the print range is. But it's not a matter of it being 42 rows. It's always going to be that answer plus 18 because our headings are starting in row 18. All right, so here's how we're going to solve this problem. I want to come back to formulas and then name manager. All right, and here's real life, folks. We have a lot of names that have changed to reference errors. I'm going to scroll down and look for the name called print area, and there are actually two. There's one on the landlord sheet and one on the tenant statement sheet. I'm on the tenant statement sheet, so that's the one I want to edit. We're going to come here, and right now it refers to a specific range, a hard-coded range, which is, I guess, what you would expect. That's what most print ranges are. But I'm going to change this to be the offset function, and we're going to start from the A1 cell every single time. From the A1 cell, the next two parameters are how many rows down we want to go, no rows down, and how many columns over do we want to go, no columns over. That's to get to the starting cell. All right, so I want to start at A1. I don't want to go any rows from there. But then I want to go 18 high plus the count of tenant statement. You have to put the worksheet name in here. Exclamation point, dollar sign A, colon, dollar sign A, comma, and then how many columns wide? Well, I'm just going to hard code that to be 6 because I can see that the report goes out through F there. All right, so let's cover offset again. You start from a specific cell. Offset lets you move down and over to get to the new starting cell. Well, in this case, A1 is the right spot, so 0, 0. And then how tall do you want the range to be? 18 plus the count, and then how wide? 6. All right, we will accept that. Missing a parenthesis right there. Check it again. Good. Click close. All right, so now if we do Control P for print, you'll see that they are going all the way down to the end of the print range. We'll turn back to the spreadsheet. Let's go. What was it? Nancy Drew. We'll copy Nancy Drew in Control C. Come over here, paste that into those two cells. We get less records, and you see the print range has already changed as soon as those formulas have changed. So it's looking over here in column A for those dates. You know, I couldn't use rent or payment because those are not all filled in all the time. Finding the column that had nothing else in the column except for the numeric values that I wanted, and then adding 18. To get this count up here. Of course, we can delete that. That was just for illustration. Okay, there you go, a rather complicated solution, but no macros required to have that print range automatically extend using the offset function. All right, well, I want to thank Michael for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.